श्री राधा वल्लभ लाल की जय। श्री सद्गुरुदेव भगवान की जय। श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय। श्री हरिवंश, as per the instruction, as per the guidance and by the grace of Pooja Maharaji, I am here to directly translate whatever Pooja Maharaji has said about the glories of Sri Vrindavan Dham and how to attain the divine transcendental love of Sri Priya Pritam. So this humble effort has been put forward to reach a wider range of audience who cannot understand Hindi language. So please don't take this to be my perspective, my point of view. It is the direct translation of Pooja Maharaji's voice. So whatever good, whatever beneficial you find with this discussion, take it as the direct grace, compassion, blessings of Pooja Maharaji. And whatever faults, whatever mistakes you find, please ignore them, considering me as a beginner. I humbly bow down to everybody present. Moving ahead with the discussion, we were discussing Sri Radha Kripa Kataksh Strot sung by Lord Shiva, who is glorifying Sri Radharani, and we were to discuss the seventh stanza, and here we go with the seventh stanza. Mrinal Val Vallari Tarang Rang Dorlate Latagra Lasilol Neel Lochanavalokane Lalan Lulan Milan Manogya Mugdha Mohanashriye Kada Karishasihima Kripa Kataksh Bhajanam Kada Karishasihima Kripa Kataksh Bhajanam. Lord Shiva here is again describing, glorifying the beauty of the form of Sri Radharani. He is discussing about the beautiful arms of Sri Radharani, that how her hands look like. He has compared the hands, the arms of Sri Radharani with the beautiful stalks of the lotus, of the lotus flower. It's like they are the beautiful stalks of the lotus flower, because we have seen the stalks of the lotus are, it's very thin, and at the end the beautiful lotus flower comes and blossoms. Similarly, the arms, the hands of Pyariju are very, the arms are very thin and they are very soft, very tender, and they have been compared to the stalking of the lotus flower, and the hands at the end are compared to the beautiful lotus. For example, if we just go for the color, the beautiful color of the stalks of Priyaju is again the tinge of the white, the gaurvarn, the white color, and a molten gold mix in it and a bit of redness in it. And the hands of Sri Priyaju are red in color, like the lotuses are red in color, so they look very tender and very beautiful. And what the personal associates of Sri Priyaju has done on the hands, on the palm of Sri Priyaju, they have done beautiful skin art. And that skin art is actually just magnificently increasing the beauty of the palms. Already the hands of the palms of Priyaju are very beautiful. They are stealing the hearts of Shyam Sundar, and with the skin art that has been done on the palms of Sri Priyaju, Sri Radharani, that is magnificently greatly increasing the beauty, and that is just mesmerizing Shyam Sundar. So this is the beauty of the hands, the arms and the palms of Sri Priyaju, which has been glorified in Chaturasi Ji, where Mahaprabhu is saying Bhuj Mrinal Bal Harat Balayajut Paras Saras Shravani Shyam Sis Taru Manu Midwari Rachir Ruchir Ravani. And again he is saying, Mahaprabhu is saying in another verse of Sri Chaturasi Ji, where he is saying that Mano Mrinal Bhushan Bhushit Bhuj Shyam Anspar Dari Jai Shri Hit Harivansh Jugal Karini Gaj Bihrat Van Priya Pyari Avat Shri Vrishabhan Dulari. He is trying to say that these soft hands of Priyaju how is she placing? She's placing on the shoulders of Sri Shyam Sundar. And when Shyam Sundar gets the touch, when these hands embrace Shyam Sundar, he is totally mesmerized, his mind is totally captured, and he becomes so restless and he's unable to control the happiness. There are thunderstorms prevail. There's as if there's a huge storm that is prevailing in his heart, and he's so happy because every time Priyaju embrace him, every time these hands, the great hands of Priyaju, comes on the shoulder of Shyam Sundar, it gives a new feeling to him, because everything in Nikunj is new. There's every time there's a new character to every pastime, to every action, to every reaction. So Shyam Sundar feels a lot more happier than the previous time. So this is the beauty of the hands, the palms of Priyaju, and the way they are attracting and capturing the mind of Sri Lalju Maharaj. Then Lord Shiva is discussing, he's saying, Lata Grilasya Lolani Lalochana Valokane. Here he's discussing that the eyes of Priyaju are so intoxicating, and it seems as if they have been compared to the beautiful vines, the vines of the forest of Sri Vrindavan Dham. As the vines, they just strangle here and there, they just move here and there. Similarly, the eyes of Priyaju are moving here and there. They have a lot of agility in them, and this agility is just capturing the heart of Shyam Sundar. It's just stealing the heart of Shyam Sundar, and there's so much blue radiance that these eyes are throwing on Shyam Sundar that he's being totally showered by the spell, that the intoxication spell that has been created by Priyaju, and he forgets everything, and he feels like just looking at the beauty of Priyaju, even a second of separation just creates so much burning sensation. His heart burns like anything. If he even feels that there's have been a separation of a picosecond, because we don't have another measure of time, so even a small moment of separation is a very heartbreaking situation, creates a very heartbreaking situation for Shyam Sundar. Such are the eyes of Priyaju, which are radiating so much beauty, so much elixir, so much grace on Shyam Sundar, that he is totally mesmerized. That nectar that is coming, the divine nectar that is coming from the eyes of Priyaju, is totally capturing, totally attracting, totally mesmerizing the whole mind, the whole body, although Shyam Sundar's body is no material, it's all transcendental, then also it's being totally captured by Sri Priyaju. And they are compared, even the eyes and even the hands of Priyaju are being compared as if they are the lotuses, as we have just discussed. These lotuses are there in the reservoir of love, and they are moving on the, for example, when there are waves in the river and the lotuses, they just sway from one point to another. Similarly, the hands, the eyes of Priyaju have been compared to lotuses, and they are just swaying from one point to another, and that is creating such a magical situation, that is just giving a picture perfect situation, picture perfect condition, and that is stealing, that is capturing the heart of everybody present in Sri Vrindavan Dham, or all the Sakhi Parikars and the most beautiful Shyam Sundar. The hearts of everybody has been stolen by these beautiful lotuses, which are the palms, the hands of Sri Priyaju, and the eyes of Priyaju, which are like a magician, and they are just displaying, they are just creating the magic on each and everybody's heart. Such is the greatness, such is the beauty of the eyes, of the form, of each and every figure, of each and every part, body part of Priyaju, which is full of beauty, which is like each and every body part is radiating such great beauty, such great radiance that it's we, the Sakhis, the Shyam Sundar is unable to just hold it within. There's so much as if somebody is just the origin of beauty or the essence of beauty has been spread in such a great amount that it's now difficult to withhold. Such is the condition with the beauty of Priyaju that it's excessive. It's so much excessive in nature that it's very difficult. Just imagine the beauty. There's so much excessiveness of beauty that has been displayed by the form of Priyaju that it's become difficult to just withhold or just take it by the eyes of Sakhi Parikar, who himself are so transcendental in nature, and Shyam Sundar himself, who is the greatest, the great personality himself. It becomes very difficult for them to just absorb that beauty. Such is the beauty of Priyaju, which cannot be described by these material words. Then Lord Shiva is saying in the third line, Lalan lulan milan manogya mogdha mohanashriye kada kareshasi himam kripa kataksh bhajanam. He's saying that Priyaju is so youthful, her smile is so playful, and her each and every activity is so tender, so full of melody, that it is stealing the heart of Shyam Sundar. And how we are saying it again and again, that it is capturing, it is attracting, it is stealing, it is mesmerizing, it is creating a magic on Shyam Sundar. Now very beautifully Dhruv Das Ji Maharaj has described that how the beauty of each and every body part of Priyaju is creating that magic on Shyam Sundar. Now he's saying about the beauty, that how his the whole body, the whole form is creating that magic. He is saying, Roop ki si fulvari, fuli rahi sukumari, ang ang nana rang, naval niharahi, nain kar kamal, adhar hai bandhuk mano, dasan jalak par kundwari darahi. बेंदी लाल है गुलाल नासिका सुवर्ण फूल मोती बने जहां जहां जूही सी विचार ही छवि ही के खंजन रसीले नैन प्रीतम के खेले ताहा ध्रुव सखी चिते प्राण वार ही छब छब ही के खंजन रसीले नैन प्रीतम के खेले ताहा ध्रुव सखी चिते प्राण वार ही. He is beautifully describing the beauty of Priyaju in the manner. He is saying that Priyaju is looking so beautiful, the form, the grace of Priyaju is so much, it cannot be just described, the way she is portraying her beauty and the way her grace, her radiance is coming out of her form. And what is happening? This is making Shyam Sundar go restless and he's helpless. His situation has become helpless and he is become at point, he's at, there are times when Shyam Sundar becomes unconscious, and at these times the Sakhi Parikar, the Sakhis, the personal associates of Shri Priyaju are helping him to withstand the form, the grace of Shri Priyaju. Then he is describing, Shri Dhruv Das Ji Maharaj is describing the beauty, where he is saying that the eyes of Priyaju are like the lotuses, and the beautiful smile with white teeth is actually stealing the heart of Shyam Sundar, and it feels that we should give everything, we should surrender, or we should just give away everything on this beautiful smile that Priyaju possess. And then he's describing the beautiful ornaments which is on the forehead of the Priyaju, and he's saying that it is so beautiful, her nose is so beautiful, like a golden flower, as if, and a bit of redness added to it. And this beauty is making Shyam Sundar so restless, and he is like the Khanjan bird. Khanjan is a bird which is just freely moving in this whole reign of Priyaju, and is just getting the most beautiful and just taking the glimpses of the beautiful, the beauty of Priyaju, and he is free to just take or just drink that nectar which is coming from the form of Priyaju. That is why Durdasi Maharaj is saying that the eyes of Shyam Sundar are like the bird of, like the bird Khanjan, who is very free to just move around in this whole reign of Priyaju. The form, the reign of Priyaju has been described in the manner that the form, the beauty of Priyaju is such that Shyam Sundar is very free to take that transcendental nectar that is coming, which is emerging from her form. And secondly, Dhruv Das Ji Maharaj is saying in the second pad, in the second verse, he's saying that Pranahu te pyari sukumari ju ko dekhat bihari ju ke rom rom lochan hoye jaat hai jyo jyo roop paan kare nimesh na chain dhare tyon tyon pyaas bade ati kyun na aghat hai chabi ki tarangani mein jhulat kisor piya harat na heri heri khare lal chaat hai हित ध्रुव आरत में भयो भ्रम चाहत ही मिले हैं कि नाही मन क्यों ना पत्यात है. Here he is very beautifully describing the desire that Shyam Sundar is suffering from. He is saying that whenever Shyam Sundar sees the beauty of Priyaju, it feels as if Shyam Sundar, the whole, he feels that each and every pore that is present in the body has been transformed into the eyes, and each pore has become eyes. Now imagine there are so many pores and each pore has become the eye of Shyam Sundar, so that it could just take the nectar, the transcendental nectar of the beauty of Priyaju. And the more he see the beauty of Priyaju, the more that desire, the quest of the thirstiness is increasing in the heart of Shyam Sundar, and he feels that, oh, this is the first time that I have seen the beauty of Priyaju. Oh, this is the first time I am seeing the beauty of Priyaju or the Priyaju herself. Such is that feeling that he is getting, that, oh, before, from the point now before, I have not seen Priyaju, and this is the first time I'm seeing Priyaju. And then he says that each and every time when he sees Priyaju, he's getting a feeling that I should be just looking at her face and nobody should come in between and separate us. This is the inner desire which Shyam Sundar is just keeping and just asking or is just trying to fulfill by seeing the beauty of Priyaju. And what happens to him, that there is a very enigmatic situation that Shyam Sundar suffers, that although he's sitting with Priyaju, although they are having a beautiful pastime, but suddenly he realizes that the whole flow of beauty that is coming from Priyaju, which is new at every time. So this creates a very confusing state of mind, and he feels as if this is the first time I'm seeing Priyaju. So such is the love. This is the feeling of love. This is the beauty of love which Shyam Sundar is portraying. And Dhruv Das Ji Maharaj has beautifully said or explained that how his love, his eagerness is, can be seen when he is actually looking at the beauty of Priyaju. So these are the verses which clearly describe how Priyaju, how Radharani is beautifully just seated in the beautiful forest of Sri Vrindavan Dham, and her each and every body part is just stealing and mesmerizing and capturing the mind, the senses of Shyam Sundar. And again, Lord Shiva is asking that when would that time come that I could also be that instrument, that object of your grace, and I could also get that devotional bhakti, or I could get that devotion in your lotus feet, and I just want to surrender to your lotus feet.